Hello, and welcome back to Wall Street Trading's Complex Leveraged Buyout Modeling. Now what I like to do is go back to our cash flow balance sheet, and indeed, our numbers match. Income statement as well. So now what I want you to do is flip to your income statement, check your numbers here, your net income of $837 in 2009, your interest expense cleared through, your balance sheet continues to balance, we are all set. Now, I want to make sure, let's see if there's anything else we need to highlight in pink. No, we're all set here. What I want to do now is I want to go back to LBO summary, and I want to change this to a no transaction X1. And check this out. You are still back at $5.11, which you can check every number here against your core standalone projection model that we had saved as a separate file, so you can check the numbers do indeed match. Now what I want to do is I'm going to change that back to LBO. I'm going to change also the LBO into purchase recap accounting. My balance sheet continues to balance, all checks out to zero. I'll make that a refinancing all debt, still zero. Excellent. Change that back to a zero. Purchase accounting and refinance all. I'm just toggling through all of the different possibilities here. So we're looking good. We're actually done building this core model here, but let's first go ahead and update the ratios page and build our IRRs, and then we're truly done. And then I will tell you what to do here if you're taking our complex leveraged buyout course. So here at this point, I want you to go to ratios, and I want you to go to H8 and grab in my ending term loan balance. So H8 on the ratios, you will say equals, control page up to the debt suite, and get me H19. I'm going to make this, we'll make it pink in a second. Senior notes, same thing, equals, get me the senior notes, which is H25. Okay. H8 equals debt sweep H19. H9 equals debt sweep H25. I will make both of these two pink, and I will carry them both across to the right. 2009, column M.